of wrestling's best athletes battle each other in hopes of winning the sport's newest treasure. But they must first conquer its most unique matches. The American Wrestling Association presents All-Star Wrestling and the Team Challenge Series. Today, the tale of the Beauty and the Beast takes on a new twist with two beauties and two beasts. The Magnificent Mimi and Colonel of Ears battle Candy Devine and Baron Von Raschke. Can you guess who are the beauties and who are the beasts? Let's go into the announce booth with Ralph Strangis and Greg Gagne.
Thank you, Lee Marshall. Welcome to All-Star Wrestling. I am ringside, Ralph Strangis, and this is Greg Gagne.
And what a program we've got today, Ralph.
We've got a superlative 60 minutes of wrestling action. You will see Sergeant Slaughter, America's hero, also the Russian Brood, and you asked for it, you got it, the Mixed Tag Team Team Challenge Series main event.
Beauty and the Beast, you fans voted last week, you wanted to see it. Well, Sergeant Slaughter's team can make a move. He has Colonel DeBeers and Mimi against Baron Von Raschke and Candy Devine.
And right away, I want to talk about Joe Blanchard and the new rule changes for the 90s. These rules are instituted to give the wrestlers a better chance at not getting killed out there.
Well, we've had a lot of serious injuries over the past few years due to wrestlers jumping off the top rope. So, Ralph, here's what the new rules are. If a man is elevated, in other words, like the move the Destruction Crew makes where they get a man on their shoulders and another man jumps off the top rope, a team or a man will be disqualified for that move. If a man is in the prone position on the mat and a man jumps off the top rope on him, he will be disqualified. Also, a man thrown over the top rope or run into the ring post intentionally, those will be disqualifications in the AWA.
And you mentioned over the top rope and also the ring post. Those are subjective calls that will have to be made at the time by the referee in his judgment whether or not those are deliberate and intent to injure. So, we've got a great 60 minutes of wrestling action. Highlighting right away the long left arm of the law and the trooper. They're standing by in the ring. Let's go now to the introduction.
Economic.
And Hollywood Tonight. Making his way to the ring. He weighed in at 285 pounds from Columbia, South Carolina. Here he is. Here's the trooper.
There he is, unbeaten in the AWA. The trooper, deputizing with the badges and high-fiving. The great crowd on hand today, Greg.
Capacity crowd, Ralph, and they're all up on their feet for the trooper. You know, it was last week when this former All-American football player from South Carolina stepped in the ring with Mean Mike Enos in that big football challenge match, and it was quite a match. If you missed that one, hang on this week. Beauty and the Beast match still coming up, the one you fans picked.
You ask, we listen. And the trooper now is getting ready to disrobe and do business. He is 285 pounds, and this guy is cut on a rock, Greg.
There's no fat on that body, Ralph. You know, he played football. He's a hard trainer. He played with the Atlanta Falcons, the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, and he knows what it's like and what you have to do to get in that ring. See, look at the power of this young man.
Holy cow. And Ken Carlson saying, I don't know if I want to be in the AWA. This is his first appearance.
He's just looking around like he wanted a way out, and I don't
look at that. Got a way out as the troopers set him flying.
The trooper's really fired up today. You know, he's got Destruction Crew on his mind. Him and Paul Diamond had formed a tag team, and they were the World Tag Team Champions back in the ring. I can't blame him one bit.
Takedown by the trooper. And now a warning that he pulled the back of the hair. That's what the trooper was asking for. As Carlson dug in just a little bit. Boy, you got to look for every advantage that you can get when you're wrestling a big guy like the trooper. There was a knee inside.
Trying for that side headlock there.
Oh! Big shoulder block. Yeah, as he ran straight into 285 pounds of stone.
Right there, that's great technique for a man that size, 6'4", on that arm drag. I mean, he also not only is strong, but he has some great wrestling ability.
And now with the arm bar, really looking to dispense more pain to Kent Carlson. The trooper is one of Baron's blitzers, and he's a guy that's, well, one of the favorites in that camp as he's helping him get points and keep the Baron in first place in this Team Challenge Series. And you can bet the Baron is looking on today to watch his boy wrestle.
Well, you know, when the first Team Challenge Series was picked, the captains picked their teams, everybody said Baron Von Raschke, not much of a chance. And here it is, we're third of the way through the season, and they're leading. And it's because of men like the trooper, who, like you said, is undefeated for Baron's blitzers.
Cooper making a big impact in the AWA and making an even bigger impact on the left shoulder of Kent Carlson. Oh, you can see the pain etched across his face.
Carlson, it looks like he's lost up there, and I can't blame him one bit. He doesn't know where to go now. Go for the eyes of the Trooper. And now he's going to take it to him, and if he's got to stay on the Trooper. That's the only way he's got a chance in there.
Delivering some blows up high. Now the shoulder inside, and Trooper in a little trouble in the corner. And then pounding his way out of it with that big left arm. The long left arm of the long Trooper, and then some inside chops to back it up.
You can hear that chop way up in the top row of the arena here.
Oh, tossing him aside like a bag of garbage. Trooper, flying left kick.
Well, that should be a... You can see the face of Kent Carlson. He is out of it.
And the Trooper gets up high for a big man, setting up the backdrop. And then digging in, look at this, setting up for the big pitch. This is how the Trooper likes to finish him, cutting out the supply of the blood to the brain. And it's just a matter of seconds here for Carlson.
The only way he can get out of this is getting to those ropes, and I don't think he's going to make it. He's got a tremendous grip, and he's got it locked in good.
You can see the limp arms of Kent Carlson counted twice. Three times he's out and down. He rolls him back over, and he's going for that pad, his citation pad. Truth, justice, what is it, liberty and justice for all, just so that when Kent Carlson finally comes out of the fog, he can remember that it was the Trooper that done him in.
It was the Trooper that branded him and put him down and out. The Trooper's an amazing young man, Ralph. I think he's going to go a long way in the sport of professional wrestling. And Larry Zbyszko, 1990, looking forward to Trooper in.
Paul Diamond over there, that's his tag team partner. They got their eyes set on the Destruction Crew. And right now, Ken Carlson's eyes are spinning.
Well, you see, Carlson came off those ropes, and he was going to try to leap over the Trooper. But with that frame of his, that 6'4", there was no way. And he set him up with that backdrop, and then into the big pinch. Carlson trying to get to the ropes. And like I said, there was no way to get out of the grip of the law enforcer, the Trooper.
And
good
right,
night, Irene.
Let's go to Eric Bischoff, standing by ringside.
All right, Trooper, congratulations on that win. I've got to ask you, though, you and Hard Rock Paul Diamond, it wasn't that long ago that you two had a shot at the Tag Team Championships of the World and indeed did hold those titles, even though it was just for a few short moments before the decision was reversed. Now, I've got to ask you, you've got to be looking for another shot at the Destruction Crew.
Well, since I've been in the AWA, a lot of good things have happened. And one of the best is my teaming up with Paul Diamond. And you were right. We were tag team champs. And regardless of what man we pinned, we did pin the Destruction Crew. And we did win the belts. And we want another shot at them. And with this man right here, we can win.
How about it, Paul Diamond?
That's right, Eric. You know, it's really simple. We had the belts for a moment. They still got them now. But we're ready anytime they want. The Trooper and the Hard Rock want them right in this ring right here. And we'll take care of business.
Well, we heard right before the break from the Trooper and Paul Hard Rock Diamond. Promoters are working as we speak to sign them for the big rematch against the Destruction Crew for the title. Hard Rock and Trooper.
You know, I've got an idea, Ralph. I've got an idea. Fans, call in and vote. Okay. Let the promoters know that you want to see the Diamond and Trooper against the Destruction Crew. It was the fans that picked the main event today, Beauty and the Beast, by calling their phone line. Call now.
And the fans can also help pick the wrestler of 89, 1-900-896-2100. Give us a call. Huh, today, talk about a main event, the Beauty and the Beast. Those guys need the points, DeBeers and Mimi.
They certainly do, and Sergeant Slaughter's putting a lot of pressure on DeBeers, and DeBeers doesn't like it.
Well, let's hear from DeBeers and Mimi right now. They are the feature today on the Team Challenge Series main event.
America is again blessed to have Colonel DeBeers in their presence. But you know, I'm very upset this evening because I'm involved in a Beauty and the Beast match. Obviously, you're the Beauty. Slaughter must think I'm the Beast. Well, in South Africa, the women do not have to wrestle to make a living. We do not need a two-income household in South Africa to make ends meet. We don't have to send our women to work in the ring. So, Mimi, I know that if I ask you, you would pull your weight, but it won't be necessary. I'll take care of Baron von Raschke. And if that other girl gets her nose in the way, I'll slap it.
And I'll make sure it slapped. Let me tell you, Colonel. A victory over Candy Devine is a big plus for me. Plus, it puts points on my team.
Oh, I'll tell you what, there is dissension among the ranks of Sergeant Slaughter's camp.
Well, Ralph, you've covered NFL football, and you've covered NHL hockey and NBA basketball, and you know what dissension will do on a ball club. And if DeBeers and Slaughter can't pull it together, I don't look for them to get back in the race.
And, well, a team that's going a little bit better is Baron von Raschke's club. We'll hear from the Baron and Candy Devine a little bit later about the upcoming Beauty and the Beast match. But right now, standing by is the captain of that aforementioned club. It is Sergeant Slaughter, America's hero, G.I. Joe. Let's go to the ring for the announcements.
Ladies and gentlemen, this next matchup is one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing first, already in the ring, he hails from Atlanta, Georgia. This is W.T. Jones.
Kids on here tonight, Ralph. This arena is jam-packed with the AWA wrestling. And Sergeant Slaughter, you know, he's having a lot of problems on his team right now. Team Challenge Series. Getting a lot of heat from Colonel DeBeers and a lot of the other wrestlers saying that he's not handling the team properly.
Well, you know, he runs his camp very militaristically. And he's got a lot of individuals on his team. Tanaka, Johnny Stewart, Jerry Blackwell, the Magnificent Mimi, just to name a few. And, you know, you got to handle these people a little bit differently, much like the Los Angeles Rams and the Cleveland Browns and the Minnesota Vikings in football. You got to make a team out of individuals. Slaughter now in third and last place in the Team Challenge Series has not been able to put it together.
Well, right now you could say that Baron von Raschke is the team of the 49ers because they are really working as a unit. Slaughter, you're right, Ralph. He hasn't quite been able to pull that team together, and he's put a lot of pressure on himself. You know, and next week they've got that big fist match, another match that the fans voted to see. And Baron von Raschke picked the man who has the heart punch, the Russian brute. And he'll be stepping in against, from Sergeant Slaughter's team, himself, Sergeant Slaughter, to meet the Russian brute in a taped fist match.
Should be very interesting. You asked for it, we listen on the AWA fan line. There's Sergeant Slaughter. Very ceremoniously taking off the hat.
This match will be the time limit will run out before he gets all his gear off. He's a big man, 303 pounds, 6'5". He's stepping in with a big one in W.T. Jones.
And now he and W.T. at ring center. Now the Sarge putting him in a side headlock, working him up top on W.T. Jones. You know, the Sarge is a big guy, and he uses a lot of military tactics. We talked about this at the special Team Challenge Series. He also goes in there. Now you see complaints that he's pulling the hair, if you will, and I say it singularly.
The one hair.
The hair. The bully you see. I mean, I don't know what that is back there. Some have speculated that it's fastened by super glue, that it's not really a growth of hair at all by W.T. But
oh, if it was super glued, that thing would come flying off there when the Sarge grabs a hold of it. But he didn't grab his hair or his ponytail, whatever that is.
And
beautiful. That's the reverse.
Nice.
That's the top wrist lock. Beautiful reversal by Sergeant Slaughter. You know, for a big man, there's complaining
about
hair
again. You can hear him loudly. He's pulling my hair. Get him off me. He's pulling my hair. And now the Sarge demonstrating the technique to the referee. And he's saying, okay, you can do it, but you can't get the hair. Almost like face masking in football, Greg, where even grazing across that face mask may give the referee an indication that the face mask has been pulled. You just got to stay away from that area.
You definitely do, but Sarge was away from it, you know, and the referee cannot catch everything. And I think W.T. is trying to get Slaughter to lose his cool here. You know, when any athlete loses his cool in competition, he makes mistakes. And that's, I think, what W.T. is trying to do, is get
the Sarge to
open up, to loosen up, and then go after him.
Well, now, W.T., we have seen in recent weeks on the AWA, he has used the tactic of biting his opponent's arms to try and break out of holds and deliver some punches. There was a big head to the midsection, but you see the Sarge has the pads on, and it's hard to get a piece of him anyway.
He's getting a pretty good piece of the Sarge right here, and he's owing that big headbutt. He's got the Sarge rocking and rolling here. Now, what he has to do, he better not be admiring what he's doing in the ring. He better stay on the Sarge. A lot of young wrestlers make that mistake when they're in there with a veteran. Don't give him a chance. Don't give him their second win. When they get that second win, it could be Katie bar the door.
But right now, it's Sergeant Slaughter who's wondering when the tide is going to turn as he is draped over the ropes, looking at concrete on the outside of the Matt here.
That was a great turnbuckle there by WT, and the Sarge almost hit his head on that ring post when he went over that top rope. Oh, he'd have gone to the floor, it would have been a disqualification, the match would have been over.
And you can see WT with 313 pounds slamming it. Oh, the Sarge rolls out of the way, and WT caught the worst of that one.
One of the new rules passed down by Joe Blanchard. If WT would have gone to the top rope and come off on Sergeant Slaughter in the prone position, would have been a disqualification.
Yep. Absolutely. There are some new rules for the 90s, and we'll go through those as the matches progress. There's the Sarge meeting him with an elbow, saying, "How do you do, WT? My turn, baby." Into the turnbuckle, then off up, back, dropping down.
Well, Sarge has control now. He's taking command. And now WT, if he gets an opening, he's going to have to go for the Sarge.
Did you see the Sarge get up?
I definitely did. I've seen that in the past. You know, he's 6'5", 303 pounds, and he got both feet in the face of WT on that drop kick.
Oh, he missed the elbow, but then ducked under it. Oh, and then taking him down. WT is...
Oh, here he goes. He's calling for the Cobra Clutch.
Up the Cobra Clutch to finish off WT Jones, and you don't get out of this hole.
What we've seen right here is the Trooper used the big pinch, and now the Sarge used a Cobra Clutch. A form of a sleeper hold, both of them, and both men victorious because of their hold.
G.I. Joe, America's hero, Sergeant Slaughter, doing it in fine fashion against W.T. Jones, much to the liking of this capacity crowd here on hand, watching things go down the way the Sarge likes to see it.
Here was the big setup. He went for the clothesline, or the big elbow. He dropped. Quick moves by the Sarge here. Dropping down, coming back up, and the big clothesline.
Showing a lot of agility for a big man. Then he reached in for the Cobra Clutch, and that was about it.
You can hear the kids, "Go, Joe, go!"
Let's go now to Eric Bischoff, standing by with Sergeant Slaughter.
Sergeant Slaughter, I've got to ask you point blank, right off the bat. Your team is trailing in the Team Challenge Series substantially. Now, there's been a lot of speculation by professional sports writers, wrestling writers around the world, that perhaps it's because you're putting too much pressure on yourself, and maybe because you're a little too preoccupied with Colonel DeBeers. How about it?
Well, you know, Sergeant Slaughter's been down before. The United States of America has been down before. This is a war. And sometimes you win battles, sometimes you lose battles. It's who's left standing at the end of the war. It's true. I have been preoccupied. I have been busy all over the world promoting the number one toy company in boys today, G.I. Joe. But I am now finished. I have visited many children in the hospital, many little boys and girls dying. I have visited parents. I visit the veterans, but now it's time to get down to what I live for, and that's wrestling. And I have taken my team. I have been absent, and they have been going down, but now I'm back, and things are going to start going up.
Okay, one question before we run out of time. You must know by now that you were signed to face the Russian Brute in a taped fist match. Now, that decision came by the AWA Championship Committee, the result of the fan line vote. How do you feel about the Brute, and how do you feel about that taped fist match?
Well, next week, I heard Barabarovsky pick the Russian Brute for his man to be in that taped fist match. And I looked at everybody on my team, and I said, what a way to start out by me going in the ring against the Russian Brute in a taped fist match right here on television next week. So I'm going to wrestle you, Brute. I'm coming out with my fist taped. And when it's all over, I, Sergeant Slaughter, Not only will be left standing with my hand in the air, but my team's going to get you more points. And Baron, it's all going to be bye-bye for your team.
All right, that'll be here right next. And next week, stay tuned, because coming up next, we're going to have a chance to take a look at the man Sergeant Slaughter's going to face next week. We'll be right back. We are back at All-Star Wrestling. Well, Sergeant Slaughter made it official before the break. He said, I'm just going to take it myself.
I think the Sergeant's putting too much pressure on himself, Ralph. I know his team is trailing, but Sarge, really, next week, you're putting your career on the line when you step in with the Russian Brute.
He may be taking his life into his own hands. The devastation caused by this man, the Russian Brute. Well, let's not talk about it. Let's show it to you.
You're a
holy cow! Does the Sarge know what he's up against there with the Brute?
I don't know if he really does, Ralph. You know, if he didn't need the points, he could throw Tanaka or Stewart in there and sacrifice them to the Wolves. But his team needs the points. He can't fall any further behind. So Sarge says, I'll take the job.
A very competitive Team Challenge Series. You'll see that one next week on the Team Challenge Series main event. And right now, for more on the standings, let's go to Lee Marshall for an update.
Thanks, Ralph and Greg. Well, what can you say about last week's football clash? To do it justice, the Trooper and Me Mike Enos battled to the very end in the ring gridiron. After Me Mike tossed the undefeated Trooper out of the ring, Larry Zbysko tried to detain him. But the determination of the Trooper and some help from special referee, bench warmer Bob Wurtsema, proved tougher when the Trooper scored the tie-breaking fifth score to give Baron Blitzers two more points. With those 2 points, Baron Blitzers extend their lead to 5 points over the second place Larry's Legends. Meanwhile, Sarge's Snipers stay in third place amid rumors of captain bashing. That the rumblings among the Snipers team, the members lashing out at Slaughter for his militaristic approach to the Team Challenge Series. Now you stay tuned for further developments on this situation, as well as today's main event, the Beauties and the Beasts match.
Thank you, Lee Marshall, and stay tuned because the Beauty and the Beast match is coming up later on. You fans voted for that match.
You fans can also vote for Wrestler of the Year in 1989. Call the fan line and call now.
And stay tuned because coming up next is the Russian Brute. He's Sarge's opponent next week.
Next matchup is one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing first, already in the ring, from Sturgis Bay, Wisconsin, this is Tom Bennett. And ladies and gentlemen, his opponent tonight is managed by the notorious Tom Baker, now making their way to the ring from the Republic of the USSR at 315 pounds. Here is the Russian Brute.
He's not very well liked, Greg. Russian Brute and his manager, the notorious Ox Baker. I don't think he cares.
There's a face only a mother could love. Ox Baker, Cove Camp, Missouri. That's where he's training the Russian Brute right now. And also, he says he has more surprises for the AWA.
Well, with Gorbachev introducing Glasnost, the Cold War has all but ended. But nobody told the Brute that. He prescribed to the old ways of the Soviet Union, handing out the hammer and sickle flags, showing the fist, wearing the garb. He's a big man, and he's got that hard punch. I mean, now talk about a loose cannon, huh?
That is a loose cannon, and I think that's why Baron von Raschke hasn't put him in a whole lot of Team Challenge matches. He can't trust him, and especially this guy, Ox Baker. You remember the movie Fort Apache, the Bronx? Ox Baker was one of the big stars. But he's been training the Russian Brute with that hard punch. Next week, he's going to have an opportunity to use that hard punch on Sergeant Slaughter in a Team Challenge matchup, taped fist match.
Bit of a surprise, that billing. As now the Russian Brute goes to work early on Tom Bennett. Bennett finding out what a big man the Brute is.
Well, he definitely is. I mean, that upper body on him. Look at that big barrel chest on him.
Just tossing him around, showing the fist.
Built a little bit like, who's that cartoon character? Baby Huey?
He's a big man, the Brute. Nothing cartoony about him at all. He's in here for business. Gary DeRuscia, the third man into the ring, and there a big foot up high. Now he looks over, does the Russian Brute, at Ox Baker. Ox tells him when to deliver the heart punch.
You know, Ox was very devastating with that heart punch. In fact, two very fatal injuries to two wrestlers in the past, I mean, ended their careers, put their lights out.
Looking again, trying to see if he should deliver it. And now the Brute goes back to work. You know, the Russian Brute you mentioned is going to be in that Team Challenge Series match next week.
Well, Sergeant Slaughter and Baron Von Raschke are two good friends. And now they're captains on different teams. And the Baron is putting this man with that heart punch in against Sergeant Slaughter. Slaughter's putting his career on the line next week.
And Bennett taking his life into his own hands. Like a rag doll. Ducking under. Oh, and then finding the foot of the Russian Brute.
Poor Bennett. He's a little bit groggy out there, and he made a good move ducking under the clothesline. But what has happened before, he just doesn't know where he's at, and he couldn't follow up on the move, Ralph. The Brute in total control.
And the Brute was training in the Georgian Peninsula of the Soviet Union, hauling rock.
There it is.
Oh, the heart punch. And this is it.
Oh, man.
One, two, wrapping them up for good measure. The Russian Brute.
You're dead, and I mean, your heart actually stops beating for a second or two, and boom, you go down and you are out.
He is out, and your winner, victorious, the Russian Brute, with his manager, Ox Baker.
Now, you can see he has that fist heavily, heavily taped, and when he delivers, first he comes off that elbow, sets the man up. Now he picks up that left arm, and as he's going to deliver the blow,
bam,
right on the heart.
Wow.
Lights out for Mr. Tom Bennett.
And he stepped into it. You also noticed that he looked away to the side to get the okay from his manager, Ox Baker. Ox and the Russian Brute are standing by right now, ringside. Let's go to Eric.
Oh, that's fun.
All right, Ox Baker, if I could have your attention, please. I don't know if you heard it earlier, but it sounds to me like Sergeant Slaughter is looking to use the Russian Brute to gain momentum for his team. And next week's heart punch match right here on All-Star Wrestling.
You know, fans, wrestling fans, Baron Von Raschke has finally done it. You know, last week in Kansas City, the Russian Brute knocked out Harley Race for 13 minutes. And now Baron Von Raschke has signed my Russian Brute. The fun and games. Nobody's going to laugh next week. Because Baron Von Raschke has told me one thing. Next week in this arena, in a tape fist match, he is not only going to beat up. He is going to do something that hasn't been done in a long time. We are going to put this man in the hospital. I'm going to have an ambulance brought here. I want you to knock him out in that ring. I want him told, Sergeant Slaughter. Baron Von Raschke has the number one team in the whole world. And next week, I promise all you... Hold that steady. I promise you next week, Sergeant Slaughter will be put in an ambulance and carried to the hospital. Because my Russian Brute loves to hurt people.
All right, well, that'll be here right next week, right
next
here.
Week.
Not to be like the start of another Cold War. We'll stay tuned today.
Sergeant
Nick's tag team main event.
Sergeant Slaughter.
That's coming up next. We'll be right back.
Down.
Oh, man. Get him out of here.
Welcome back. You know, you heard the obsequious one, the notorious...
The what?
The obsequious one, the notorious Ox Baker, right before the break, say, they're going to need a stretcher
to carry out Sergeant Slaughter next week.
Well, that could happen. We've seen the Russian brute with that mighty fist of his, and the way he tapes it, Ralph, it's like a cast when he hits you. So if he hits Slaughter in the heart next week, it'll be all over for the Sarge.
And in this week's Team Challenge Series main event, it is the Beauty and the Beast. We heard earlier from Colonel DeBeers and the Magnificent Mimi. Let's go now to Baron Von Raschke and Candy Devine.
Candy, I was so excited when I found out there was going to be a Beauty and the Beast match on the Team Challenge Series, going for the points. Right away, it struck me who the Beast would be.
That's right,
and then right away, it struck me who the Beauty would be. The Ladies' World Champion and the Baron against Colonel DeBeers and Magnificent Mimi for the Team Challenge Series for the points. Tell them what we're going to do.
I'll tell you one thing, Mimi. You might as well just stay home because you're no competition to me. Or better yet, why don't you go back to South Africa with the beers? You might enjoy it there.
That's right. We're coming, the Beauty and the Beast.
And we've got it coming up for you, the Team Challenge Series main event, Beauty and the Beast style.
You know, the fan line's been ringing off the hook. Everybody's calling and voting for their favorite wrestler of 1989. Call and vote now. Call your fan line.
And don't go anywhere, because coming up on the other side of this break, we've got it for you. Beauty and the Beast. Stay tuned. All-Star Wrestling, we are mega seconds away. That's just about that much.
Well, let's get there.
Oh, we got to get to the main event. Here it is. Ken, a question I want to ask you is, can Colonel DeBeers and Mimi get the points for Sarge's team? They need them badly.
I don't think so. I think there's too much dissension between DeBeers and Slaughter. I'm going with Raschke and Candy Devine.
Well, let's get down there right away. Here to the ring now and the introductions.
Ladies and gentlemen, this next matchup is a special Team Challenge Series match, a Beauty and the Beast matchup. Introducing first, on their way to the ring, she hails from Hollywood, California. Please welcome the Magnificent Mimi. She is followed by her special tag team partner from Johannesburg, South Africa, at 274 pounds. Here is Colonel DeBeers. Current AWA World Ladies Champion from Nashville, Tennessee, here is Candy Devine. And ladies and gentlemen, she is seconded by from the Republic of Germany at 273 pounds, here is Clawmaster Baron von Raschke.
Von Raschke, the Claw Master, with Candy Devine, the woman's champ. Let's go now to Lee Marshall.
The rules, ladies and gentlemen, are very simple. This is the Beauty and the Beast match. In actuality, what it is a mixed tag team match. The women can only fight the women. The men can only fight the men. It is one fall with a 30-minute time limit. Now, should the champion of the world, Candy Devine, be in the ring and tag off to her partner, Baron von Raschke, that means that the Magnificent Mimi would have to leave the ring. Her partner, Colonel DeBeers, would then have to enter. Are the rules all understood for the Beauty and the Beast match? Both teams apparently are understanding of the rules. Let's get then right to the action.
All right, Baron von Raschke and Candy Devine. The last time we saw the Baron, Greg, was in that Greco-Roman match against Wayne Bloom when the Destruction Crew teamed up at the very end of the match and really gave it to the Clawmaster, who said it would be payback time in installment fashion.
Maybe one installment is Paul Hard Rock Diamond and the Trooper. But this was a surprise move made by the Baron, you know, putting himself in this match. DeBeers, he's a master studying his opponents, identifying their weaknesses, and exploiting them. So perhaps the Baron has surprised DeBeers with this, and him and Candy can get the job done on the beautiful Mimi and Colonel DeBeers.
Now, remember, in the tag team fashion, once one of the women tags the men, both men must come in,
and have at it. You cannot have a woman and a man in the ring at the same time.
Why?
Candy going to work on the arm.
I ask why.
You ask why. It's the rules, Greg.
It's the rules.
Oh, there's a kick by Mimi. As now she begins to work on Candy. Mimi's got her eyes set on other things as well, which may be the title.
Yeah, well, she definitely does, you know, and if she could get a win over Candy Devine in this match, it'll put her right in position for a title shot at Candy Devine. So this is a big match for her. And on the other hand, if she loses, she'll go right down to the bottom of the ladder.
These two wrestlers have had at it before. No strangers to each other's tactics, and now in the tag team Beauty and the Beast match, you asked for it, you got it, and so did Candy.
Slingshot move. Colonel DeBeers wants the ring there, and I think he wants to deliver a little punishment to Candy Devine. Now, you know, there's a lot of friction right now between Colonel DeBeers and Sergeant Slaughter. DeBeers says every time there's a tough match, every time there's a little pressure on the team, Slaughter's behind. We need points. He puts me in the position. Puts me in and a Beauty and the Beast. Well, he thinks it's an insult to me, and I don't. I wouldn't mind being Mimi's tag team partner.
No, not at all. And now they go back at work, the ladies at ring center. Candy getting the best of it right now as she takes Mimi down, looking for the quick one, and Mimi kicks out.
Now either Candy or Mimi is going to have to make the tag here pretty quick. They've been in that ring awfully long. There's the tag, it's Colonel DeBeers. And here comes the Baron, and he throws that claw.
And DeBeers says, I don't want any part of this. Jerry DeRusha, very experienced referee. In the ring.
You know, the Baron is the kind of wrestler that just when you think you've got him hurt, when you think he's exhausted, he comes out of the closet with that claw hold, and it's been a very successful maneuver for him over the years and finished off a lot of opponents.
Playing sort of possum is the tactics by Baron Von Raschke. Now he goes to work on DeBeers and twists him down angrily. Working on the left arm of the Colonel. This match, you know, is a result of the fan line. The AWA gives the fans what they want. 900-896-2100. You called for it. You got it.
You talk. AWA listens.
And now he can't listen to Colonel DeBeers because he had that big foot of Von Raschke up high. Turnbuckle time for the Baron.
Here's what I was talking about a little earlier. This is when the Baron is really at his best. When you think you've got him going, you can't really tell. The Baron plays possum. He's racked up, though. That was you can hear that turnbuckle down here, and that took the wind out of Baron Von Raschke.
The Bears now going at it. Magnificent Mimi looking on. Baron with a block. Oh, he shows the claw again. The Bears says, and very quickly to retreat.
Well, he knows if the Baron gets that claw hold on him, 9 times out of 10, it's all over. If you can't get to the ropes or, in this case, make a tag to your partner, it's all over once the claw is slapped on.
More effective than the infamous Vulcan nerve pinch. Isn't that right? You've seen
Spock,
that before. Oh, yeah.
Captain Kirk.
You betcha. Yeah,
this is a little more effective than that.
And now Mimi getting the tag from DeBeers. She steps in, and so Von Raschke must yield to Candy Devine.
I think if I was Baron, I'd try to stay in there a little bit.
Oh, perhaps.
How about you, Ralph?
Yeah,
I know you would.
You betcha. Candy goes right to work again.
Oh, a Boston
Mimi.
Crab.
Got her up.
Beautiful reversal.
Nice move by Mimi. 1, 2, and out from Candy, reversing Mimi. Oh, it's back and forth here on the canvas.
Mimi had reached back there and tried to hook. Oh, went for the drop kick, but
didn't
Candy
get all of it.
Just backed out of the way.
Yeah, didn't get all of it. Got enough of it, though, I think, to stun Candy Devine. Candy off the ropes. Oh, and then delivering to Mimi. Oh, down goes Mimi.
Mimi's wearing that black pad on her arm as a result of a fractured wrist. She has a cast under there, and it's covered up. She's been instructed by the officials and President Joe Blanchard, if she uses it as a weapon in the ring, she will be disqualified.
Well, now, Candy Devine is the woman's champion. Candy got the title when Wendy Richter retired and they held a tournament up in Canada. Candy won that title
and has yet to relinquish it. Mimi is seeking it, and now Mimi is seeking Candy in the corner with the Beers helping out. But Lucia can't see it. His back is turned.
Baron von Raschke coming in, and referee, look at Colonel the Beers hanging on to Candy Devine. Come on, referee. Turn around. That would be a disqualification.
And Mimi working on Candy. Baron, as of right now, is in first place, but Candy taking a lot of punishment from the Magnificent One as she picks her up and sets her down. Then goes right for the splash. Candy kicking out.
I have to give Mimi a lot of credit. You know, she could have backed out of this match with that cast on her arm, but she wants Candy Devine. She wants a shot at that title. She doesn't want to let the opportunity slip out of her hands. If she didn't compete in this match, she might not ever get a title match.
Up with the elbow. You mentioned you got to watch that cast. And she did not use the cast in that maneuver.
Well, she generally abides by the rules when she's in the ring. Now she's got her by the hair. But I'm sure this is as a result of being teamed up with Colonel the Beers.
Felicia counting it out. They got to let go of the hair.
Beautiful step in hip lock. Mimi's showing a lot of technique and a lot of good wrestling ability here. She's really surprised me. She's been training hard, and the goal that she has set for herself is the championship.
Mimi and Candy Devine getting down on the canvas. You see the wrist locked up. The Beers with the tag, and Baron saying, come on, Colonel. Come on, Colonel. Apparently the tag was not made.
No, what he's doing is reaching in. Look at, he's holding, putting pressure on the back of the neck of Mimi so she can get more pressure on that arm stretcher that she has on Candy Devine.
Felicia in tight, can't really see it. Now in the corner, they go at it again. That's in the wrong side of the tracks as far as Candy's concerned.
Here we go again.
He's going to work on Mimi. Felicia is tied up with Action across the ring, and Candy's taking it.
Look at
the Beers, and Mimi pushed her down.
Now she used the cast. She hit her behind the head with that cast. The referee would have seen the Beers interfering or that cast used. That match is over.
And Greg, there has been some speculation as to should we have two officials in a tag team match to watch everything.
Well, the fans should. Maybe the fans can. Look at Colonel.
Oh, again. See?
Come on, referee. The referee has got to take charge of this match. He's losing control.
And control right now favoring Mimi as Candy has taken a lot of blows.
There, Candy's got her.
Yeah. But the Colonel comes in to pull her off. Felicia doesn't see it. Mimi's got her pinned.
Got her hooked pretty good.
Three count, and Candy has it. But the win is going to go to Mimi and Devine. I can't believe it. Greg, what happened?
The referee was totally losing control of that match. He was trying to get control of it by keeping Baron von Raschke out of the ring. And when Colonel the Beers saw his opportunity when Candy had Mimi pinned, he came in and reversed it. Mimi ended up on top, and Mimi got the pinfall.
Mimi up high, saying to the crowd, hey, look what I brung you.
Now here we go. Here's where the referee is getting control, getting Baron von Raschke out. Candy Devine with a beautiful rolling cradle, and she's got Mimi all locked up. There's Colonel the Beers pulling Mimi back up on top, and she's got Candy hooked. She's got the legs hooked, the neck, the arm, and there's no way Candy Devine will kick out of that. 2 points for Sergeant Slaughter's team.
Wow. You know, we talked about two referees. Maybe we ought to think about replay.
Maybe we should think about the fans calling in and vote. Should we have two referees in a tag team match? Call the fan line.
Well, right now, let's go down to the ring and Eric Bischoff.
Baron, Candy Devine, there's nothing else to say. Simply put, you were robbed.
That's exactly right. This is for a team challenge. And I tell you this, Sarge may have gotten the points, but he turned his men loose and his girls loose, and they did it the wrong way.
That's right, I'll tell you. Colonel interfered. He pulled me off behind, pulled my hair. What's wrong with that ref? Why isn't he watching? Mimi thinks he's so smart. Get in there one-to-one on me and see how good you do that, Mimi. Just see how far you get, because you'll be down 1, 2, 3.
All right, a very disappointed and rightfully so Baron von Raschke, Candy Devine. Stay with us. We're coming back.
We have a match. One is for a series.
Right after
this. It's a team fight.
I agree. I saw it. The fans saw it.
There was this lovely. Yeah.
Everyone saw it.
The Beers, you're going to pay.
That's right.
You put your hands on Candy. You're going to pay. And that's all the people need to know.
That's right.
You're a great man, Candy. I'm proud of her.
feeling where anything can happen in the team challenge series, and it just did.
I don't think Sergeant Slaughter liked the way he got
those
2 points.
Wait a minute. Come on. Right. Yeah.
Well,
he'll
he didn't
take
like
him.
It, but he'll take
He'll take the pair, and that puts him in striking distance as Sarge's Snipers are in third place with 13 points. Larry's Legends are just 2 points ahead in second place with 15, and looking down from the top are the Baron's Blitzers. They have 20 points, and more heated team challenge series action coming up next week. You're not going to believe the 60 minutes of wrestling action we have for you. Tell them about it.
You sure you want me to?
Yes, I do. I mean,
okay,
I was on a roll
next
for a
week,
second.
Colonel DeBeers. Also, the world heavyweight champion Larry Zbyszko and the crowd favorite UConn John Nord. He'll be with us. And our big main event, the Russian Brute with the tape fist match, stepping in with Sergeant Slaughter. Don't miss it.
For Greg Gagne, Eric Bischoff, Lee Marshall, and the rest of the gang, here I'm Ringside Ralph. We'll see you next time on All Star Wrestling.